Blackstone Publishing presents The Story of Silver, How the White Metal Shaped America and the Modern World by William L. Silber. This book is read by Jim Meskimen. To Danny, you left us too soon. A lover of silver will never be satisfied with silver. Ecclesiastes 5. Main characters, in chronological order. Alexander Hamilton, America's first Secretary of the Treasury, recommended both gold and silver definitions for the U.S. dollar in 1791, and chose the $1.29 price that the mint would pay per ounce of silver bullion. He recommended bimetallism, the coinage of both gold and silver, to promote economic growth and to avoid the evils of a scanty circulation. John Sherman, U.S. Senator from Ohio, chairman of the Senate Finance Committee, used deception and misrepresentation to pass the Coinage Act of 1873, demonetizing silver and establishing gold as the sole backing for the U.S. currency. Sherman later served as Secretary of the Treasury, Secretary of State, and is most famous for the Sherman Antitrust Act, but was vilified for the so-called crime of 1873, downgrading silver, which shadowed American politics for a century. William Jennings Bryan, the 36-year-old U.S. congressman from Nebraska, captured the 1896 Democratic nomination for the presidency with the electrifying Cross of Gold speech at the convention. Despite its name, the speech was all about silver, a response to 25 years of deflation in America since the crime of 1873, pitting rural Westerners favoring easy credit against the hard money urban East. The Wonderful Wizard of Oz, published in 1900, memorialized the class battle and portrayed Bryan as the cowardly lion, whose roar is greater than his bite. Bryan ran three times for the presidency and lost. Key Pittman, elected U.S. Senator from Nevada, the Silver State, in 1913, and made a career with legislation to promote the white metal. He became the influential chairman of the Foreign Relations Committee in 1933 and led the Senate's silver bloc of Western mining states to convince the newly elected President Franklin D. Roosevelt to subsidize the price and production of the white metal. His support of silver debuted in 1918 with what was called the Pittman Act, authorizing the sale of silver to Great Britain to support the Indian rupee and then subsidizing the repurchase of the metal at above-market prices. Franklin Delano Roosevelt, elected U.S. President in 1932 in a landslide, pushed legislation with the help of Key Pittman and his allies to cure the Great Depression, including taking the United States off the gold standard. FDR repaid Pittman with a December 1933 proclamation to subsidize domestic silver production, and by signing the Silver Purchase Act of 1934. FDR's programs doubled the price of the white metal, a boon to American mines, but a catastrophe for nationalist China. Smugglers drained the white metal from Shanghai banks for sale at inflated prices on world markets and forced the Asian giant off the silver standard. Henry Morgenthau, Roosevelt's neighbor in Dutchess County, New York, and a personal confidant, became FDR's Treasury Secretary and implemented the Silver Purchase Act for the president. Morgenthau nationalized the white metal and led a buying program to make silver 25% of America's monetary reserves, but warned Roosevelt that this made nationalist China, led by American ally Chiang Kai-shek, vulnerable to an internal threat from Mao Zedong's communist insurgents and an external threat from Imperial Japan. Morgenthau abandoned the aggressive buying program in December 1935 with the approval of Key Pittman, but failed to save China. The Silver Purchase Act tipped the balance of power in Japan away from the diplomats and toward the military, contributing to the outbreak of the Sino-Japanese War in 1937. John Fitzgerald Kennedy, elected U.S. president in 1960, and assassinated on November 22, 1963, by Lee Harvey Oswald, before his main legislative initiative on civil rights could be enacted by Congress. He succeeded in repealing FDR's Silver Purchase Act in June 1963, a small step in making the white metal more readily available to industry. As a former senator from Massachusetts, home to silversmiths since the time of Paul Revere, Kennedy had long.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.